In my opinion, the best way to start the year is to reflect on the lessons you've learned from the past year and apply them to your future. So with Final Fantasy XIV wrapping up the Hydaelyn and Zodiac saga, I feel like it's time to look back at the path that got us here, with one key lesson each expansion taught us and how Final Fantasy XIV made us better. In A Realm Reborn, we learn about reconciliation by rebuilding the bonds between the Eorzean Alliance after the calamity of Bahamut, with Gridania, Limsalo Mensa, and Thanalan becoming stagnant and complacent with the current state of Eorzea, in addition to being pushed to the brink by the Gaulian Empire and considering surrender. Until the Scions come from their different walks of life to show them how to tackle problems that seem impossible alone by just working together. The lesson here is simple, but it fits the story of A Realm Reborn so well. And by learning that lesson, you can apply it to your own life by reaching out to that person that you haven't talked to in a while for whatever reason, or asking for help on something that is really hard for you. But moving into Heavensward, there are many lessons you could pull from the story. However, I think most people believe forgiveness is the lesson from that story. But I believe understanding is what Heavensward teaches us, because to truly forgive someone or to get over a situation, you must first understand their perspective. Except for obviously despicable things, I'm looking at you, Racevulgar. But this is not only shown through Ishgard and the dragons becoming true allies after learning the truth of how the war started, but even on a more personal level with Estinian and Yasel having completely opposite views upon meeting each other, only to understand later on that they both want peace even if they're doing it differently. And this could easily be applied to real life, like when you and a friend are working on a single project in different ways, only to realize you have to understand what each other are doing to make a better effort. Stormblood was the hardest expansion to find a lesson within, but I believe it's redemption and that everyone deserves a chance at it. This is expressed through the stories of Fordola and Gosetsu, two people that have killed countless others in the name of Gallimald, with Gosetsu killing 1,000 men for the Gaulian Empire to earn his freedom at Heian's side. Then Fordola joins Gallimald and became the Butcher to enact revenge against her countrymen for killing her father. Both of these characters have done terrible things for different reasons, but terrible nonetheless. But those terrible actions didn't stop them from becoming the great people they are today, with both of them saving far more lives than the ones they've taken, simply deciding to be better than they were before, and to not be shackled by the mistakes of their past. So they are a benefit to the people who knew them and the people they will meet. But with that being said, let's get to Shadowbringers. This expansion's lesson was the easiest to see because it is all about growth, which was expressed through the gameplay and story. With the addition of the trust system, the system allows your comrades, the Scions, to tackle dungeons with you for the first time, in addition to the Scions growing as people, and most of all turning the Ascians into truly sympathetic antagonists that you can relate to, giving the story of 14 a shade of gray it never had before, meaning that the developers not only pushed the game to new heights, but grew in the process as well. So just like these devs and the Scions, we should push ourselves to grow as people and come out stronger on the other side. Lastly, Endwalker teaches us that we have to have hope, because without hope, you can fall into despair, becoming a cancer to those around you and everything you touch, just like Meteon and her sisters within Endwalker. However, you and the Scions represent hope within the expansion and the entire Hydaelyn and Zodiac saga. With you liberating and saving so many people along your journey, it culminates with the Scions becoming literal beacons of hope. And this overwhelming optimism for the future becomes the foundation that lets you save Meteon, defeat the Endsinger, and get the best ending possible not only for yourself or the Scions, but everyone in the universe. Endwalker tells us that we can't live our lives without hope, because without it, what's the point of reconciliation, understanding, redemption, or growing? Hope may be the last lesson we've learned from Final Fantasy XIV so far, but I believe it's the most important since it's the trigger that will make us better. But with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you want to see more video essays on video games, anime, and other things I enjoy, or timeline videos where I recap games like Final Fantasy XIV and Tales of Arise, please like, comment, and subscribe with notifications turned on. So with that being said, it's been Skipx and I'm out.